In this video, we are going to convert this simple list into this amazing visual. I can look at details of each item, or I can look at details of all of them by flipping them. This is done using a Power BI visual called Card Browser. In this case, I'm using it to show a list of my YouTube videos, but it can be used for people, products, logos, customers. Essentially, it's a catalog visual. To use the visual, go to Power BI Desktop, go to Add Visuals, search for Card Browser and install it. Go to Insert menu and open the Visual Gallery. Scroll down, you will see Card Browser. Insert it on the canvas. Resize it, and now we will populate that visual. Before we do that, we need to understand the data we have. In the data view, I can see there are two tables. One is the list of videos, and another is a list of products. I have 31 videos, and for each video, I have an ID, which is unique, the date of publishing, title of the video and the topic, duration, actual link to the YouTube video, and the link to the thumbnail image as well. The last column is description. I want to use this link not as a link, but I want Power BI to go to that link, get that image and display the image of my thumbnail. And to do that, I need to select the column, go to column tools, data category. By default, it'll be uncategorized, but we have to tell Power BI, treat it like an image URL. We'll see the impact of this a little later. Coming to the products table, I just have three columns, name of the product, the logo link, and a color in hex format. Now these two tables are related, and that is done by going to the model view. I can drag product from here to product on videos. Now let's put data here and build the visual. It needs so many different types of data points. I need to see all the columns in my data. So go to View tab, enable the data pane and expand all the tables. The visual itself requires an ID column, which is unique. So I do have that, drag and drop. Next, let's drag drop the video title into the title section. I also have thumbnail image, which can go in under title image. Now, because we have marked it as image URL, it fetched that picture and brought it down. This requires an internet connection. I also have a product logo that goes as badge. The description itself is the content, so I put it under content. Subtitle I put as duration, so I can see the title, subtitle and content. We also have something called metadata fields. So I'm going to put the title again there, product name, the duration, the URL of the video itself. The moment I put something in metadata fields, you will notice there was a small little toolbar which came here. This shows the front part. This flips all the cards and shows the backside of all the cards. That's why it's called a card browser. I also have a color coding, so that hex color which we saw, that can be mapped as the top bar color. So now let's see what to do with the visual. Flipping we have already seen, but that's not all. Hover on any card, it will show you the content field. You click on a card, then it expands and shows you the entire content properly. And if you scroll down, it'll also show you all the items you have put on metadata. So clicking shows all fields which you have mapped. To close an expanded version, click on this button. Notice that it is showing me all the URLs. Currently, everything is shown as YouTube, but if I click on it, it knows what the URL is. It is going to give you a warning because we are going out. And it did start the video. So that's how this card browser can be a gateway to various things, which could be documents, websites, videos, product pages, spare parts pages, services pages, or people. In order to enhance it a little further, I also added another visual called Slicer. This is the new slicer, which allows you to have text as well as images. This slicer is based on the product table. So now these two will work together. If I click on it, it'll only show me videos related to PowerPoint, Power BI, Excel, and so on. Now the visual is ready. We'll publish it to the Power BI service. Once published, if you have the pro version of Power BI, you can share it with others as a link. If you don't have the pro version, then you have no choice but to send the entire PBIX file to each other or put it on OneDrive or Teams and share the link. The disadvantage of that is other people can completely edit or delete your report itself and they can see the raw data. There is a third option available where if this data was anyway for public consumption and you want this interactivity, you can actually publish this for free on your website or send a link to any customer who is interested. So let me show you how to do that. I just opened the published report on browser. On the browser, I have file menu. I have embed report published to web. And now it'll give you a simple HTTPS link. You can use that and send it to anybody. Or if you want to embed it in a website, it'll also give you the iframe based code. In either case, this is anonymous access. So when I paste this link anonymously, it's not going to ask any login, any restrictions. It's just going to show me the entire report. And now that the report is rendered on a browser, anybody can browse your content. They can flip or they can see details or they can use filtering to focus on areas of interest. So I'm sure you got a better idea of how and when to use the card browser visual. Try it out, apply it in day-to-day work, and let me know in comments where and how did you use it. So that's it for now. Thank you.